Okay, this is my last video today. But I have over here in this little crock pot in front of the window a little secret brewing. And this is going to be one of the recipes that we post this month. But I wanted to, again, talk a little bit about repurposing things. So one of the things that is very, you'll hear us talk about all the time within the paleo community, the ancestral health community, functional nutrition, whatever it is eating nose to tail. Eat every part of the animal because every part has specific nutrients and the bones are very, very nutritious. Whether that's bone broth, the collagen that's contained in them. I love to make stock out of chicken feet because there's so much collagen in them. I get the best broth out of chicken feet, out of anything that I do. But there should be no waste. And one of the reasons that our ancestors were significantly healthier than we are is because they actually ate cheaper cuts of meat, which were higher in fat and higher in nutrients. The higher the fat content, the cheaper the cut of meat, the more nutrient dense it is and the more fat-soluble vitamins there are. And the organs, which were typically reserved for the poorer people, are far more nutritious than the muscle meats. So eating organs, very, very important, very nutritious, great ways to hide them. We'll get into some of that. But I wanted to talk right now about the bones because I mentioned bone broth a couple of times in videos I've done before. We had a prime rib last night. So we actually have had prime rib a lot. It's one of my favorite things. We made two of them for our Christmas party. We made two of them for Christmas Eve. And we had one last night for New Year's Eve. Well, the one I had last night was bone in. The rest of them that we had done were already deboned, just for ease of use. But the one we had last night was bone in. And so last night after everybody ate, I took the bones and threw them in the fridge for this morning. So this morning I transferred the bones into this crock pot and I put in a little bit of the stock that I had already made from the bones before. And then I filled the rest of the way with water. I didn't actually season this because the bones had the seasoning on it from the roast. So there was garlic, salt, pepper, cumin, chili powder there. And that's going to flavor this for me. So this, I'm making a smaller batch of bone broth here because this is actually going to be the base of the next soup that I'm going to make. So all of it's in here, filled it to the top with water, put it on high, and it's going to cook all day long, probably 12, maybe I'll let it go 24 hours. As it evaporates off, put more water in for today and tomorrow until a couple hours before you're gonna stop cooking it. Then tomorrow morning when I wake up, so I'm gonna let this go all night long. Tomorrow morning when I wake up, I'm going to slice up some onions, put the onions in here, let any of the little bits of meat that fell off of the bones stay in there because I want them in my soup. And then I'm going to make a crouton, and I'm going to make a primal version. Primal means that there is dairy, but otherwise paleo version of French onion soup out of that crock pot. And so that'll be another one of the recipes as we travel around the world for our paleo passport. We're gonna head over to France.